Hello there, welcome. This is Kitchen Quarantine. So today I want to realize like a plate that's like some Hungarian origin, but I'm gonna just adapt for what we have available here at home. Plus, we have a nice result. The potato, I already peeled them and then just make them, cut them by four. So big pieces. You don't want pieces too small, otherwise the potato they're gonna dissolve, they're gonna overcook and they're gonna dissolve on the stew. So like a potato in four, so you have all regular size, more or less all the same size, though they're gonna cook evenly. Once you cut all this your potato, we're gonna go to the next step. For add extra flavor about our stew, it's very important ingredients, garlic. So I'm not gonna cut it, I just peel it and crush it. So as you see, it's broken, all the liquid from the garlic is gonna go inside our stew. I prepared as well some carrot and some celery that I didn't show you on the video. So you're gonna go with the meat. So we got some chorizo, just like sliced by rondelle. This is like 1.5 of big chorizo, so like 150 grams for more or less 500 grams of beef. So you want your beef that's been nice and a little bit fatty. So like with a high marble score, you know, with a lot of fat in the middle. Don't remove the fat from the meat because it's gonna dissolve inside your stew. So it's gonna give extra flavor and it's gonna be nice and juicy. So after we got all our meat, dice it. I dice it by cubes, like big cubes, more or less of 4x4. We go to add some flavoring. So to roughly marinate them with some pepper, olive oil, just like a spoon. I'm adding some oregano, maybe just because I'm Italian and I like oregano everywhere. Some sweet paprika, some hot paprika, smoked one. So all of these ingredients you can actually find in the supermarket, but if you have your local supplier of spice or your friend maybe from Middle East, it will be even better. I will add other ingredient that is not used to, but I want to give an extra flavor because I'm gonna give like a kind of other European twist. So I add some saffron. We usually find in a lot of like stew and soup in like Europe, like in France and Italy. You can find saffronette for bouillabaisse, for example. So this is our meat, all the spice. Gonna add some salt and we're gonna mix all of them. So now that our mise en place is ready, we can proceed to cook. So I'm heating up a pan, it's very hot. I'm gonna add some oil, a good amount. So you can tell even from the pulling the oil, it's nice and hot. And then putting all our honey. You see the stuff of this is spray. That's what you want. Then you add some salt. Like not fine salt. You should use like Maldon salt. Anyway, in this way. Because it's gonna add to break the fiber. And you let this went down and almost get like brown and orange. So that's gonna give us as well some sweetness and color for our stew. So now our onion, they're nice and wet down. They started to take some color, that's what you want. So I didn't add any water, just played with the fire. You know, a little bit, you just like to a little bit and put it in high. Now it's got very high. That's what we want now because we're gonna add our chorizo and we're gonna let it go for another little bit. So the chorizo is actually gonna release all the natural juice and the flavor, all the fat. And that's gonna give extra flavor, color, and let's color it on our cube. Connect everything to emulsify and to keep the flavor and not make it bad, because I'm gonna add a spoon of butter. So from now on, I'm doing just very, very high heat. With the device, I'm gonna burn down the butter. Not to burn myself, but cover it. So I'm gonna let go for another little bit. And then we go to the next step. So you can see, now everything starts to get nice and color. The chorizo is starting to cook. I'm gonna add the beef. The chorizo is going to take all the marination, because she wants all this flavor, all the spice. In our stew. And I'm gonna let them just quick seal. So it's like in a medium high heat, because I don't want to keep giving color to the onion or to the chorizo that I like too hard. This is gonna stay here in our stew for quite a long time. As you can see, our meat is all nice and sealed. Unfortunately, you can't smell it, but it's smelling terrible. You can smell the chorizo, the paprika, the onion, definitely. So to get sweet. Now our pot is in very high heat. First, I'm gonna replace with a red wine. It's more or less a glass, like a full glass. 200 ml. So I'm gonna let the wine to completely evaporate, to reduce to none. So it's gonna give this flavor of winey to our sauce, to our stew. So now the wine is all evaporated, it's all reduced. You can understand when from smelling and from tasting that you're not gonna feel anymore the alcohol. Now I'm gonna add the potato. Just make them stir, you know, take all the flavor from our base. And then we're gonna add a little bit of chicken stock. I'm using already made chicken stock, just for saving some time. And as well, because in this difficult time, maybe you don't have enough space in the fridge, so you can actually save some space with some more products. And this one is a dry goods, you know, so you can keep in your cupboard for a month. And that was that. So make sure it's everything covered. And let's simmer it for, I would say, around 45 minutes to 1 hour. So just until the potato are let through. It's gonna be like so I'm gonna bring to boil. And then let it simmer for say 45 minutes. So the potato, they actually gonna cook through. The onion is gonna dissolve, and we will see what's our latest result. So now our stew is going slowly to boiling. I had already the garlic. So if you have, in this case, unfortunately I don't have. You know, it's quarantine, it's kitchen quarantine. So you kind of arrange what you got. So add your carrot and your celery if you have. Give like an extra texture and some extra veg. But as I say, bring to boil and then let's simmer for 45 minutes. As you can see, our stew is ready. So first set dish, just a bowl. Make sure you have enough liquid and of the meat from our stew. I advise to serve with some crouton or some bread. And you can add some chopped parsley, so it gives like some freshness. Goes well with some nice red wine, like a Cabernet Sauvignon. We use it in this case, 19 Thrimes from Australia. It's a red blend. And goes very well. So just enjoy. So our dish of spicy stew, paprika with like kind of goulash is ready. Ready to serve, some crouton, some chopped parsley to give it some freshness. And that's all for me from the first episode of Kitchen Quarantine. Hope you follow soon and see you for the next recipe. If you have an idea, question, just write in private or some comment on the video. And thanks for the sponsor of Core, and I'll see you soon, and stay safe.